It's no secret that 2 Fort is the best map in Team Fortress 2. The perfect symmetry and openness creates an experience like no other, with plenty of space for rocket jumping, sniping, and even double jumping a scout to quickly get from one base to another. Today, I'm gonna show you some tricks you can abuse in 2 Fort to get an advantage in a situation. For pixel boosts, there's a bunch of spots you can abuse to surprise or even hide from your enemies, and most of those are in the red side of the map. However, I'm gonna start equal with both sewers. You can get into the corner of each of these holes and have a higher point from which to ambush anyone attacking you. I especially adore this spot because no one chasing you can actually see you, and you can absolutely wreck their day. For the blue base, there's not that many places to hide in when you're in a pinch. You can get on top of this intelligence sign and have a bit of a higher point from which to attack, but this one doesn't really serve a purpose. It also works in the red base. There's also a nice spot up here for you sniper players, though you will need support from an enemy player. There's a little hole from which to snipe, and the enemy can barely spot you. Just make sure not to have pink unusual cosmetics when you're up here. For one of my favorites as scout especially, you can double jump on top of this camera and ambush anyone chasing you from it. It takes a little bit of practice to nail it every time, but once you do, the reward is pretty nice. Keep in mind though, you are pretty exposed up here, so try not to move too much, but because most people in TF2 don't look up anyways, you're pretty good. This spot also works in a red base. You can also get into this whole little line up here. However, it takes more mobility than the atomizer or detonator for pyro can offer. So you can only get up here using the jetpack or the force of nature, or sticky slash rockets, of course. In the actual intelligence room, you can get on this chair and then jump onto the right side of this lamp, right above the intelligence. You are pretty exposed up here, but no one ever looks up, so it works pretty well. Now for the red base. Let's start with the basics. You can get up on and onto the corner of every single one of these pipes in the battlements. Not all of them are useful per se, but they're definitely fun spots to camp out those perky gibbous machina snipers. For my personal favorite, in the main staircase to the intelligence, you can hide up here and kill anyone trying to chase you down. No one ever expects this spot, and it's wonderful. For tramping as demo, there's a few pretty cool ones. There's obviously the bridge tramp up to the enemy base for getting your first couple of heads against the gibbous snipers, but there's some other cool ones. You can tramp up this small staircase for fast access to the spawn, or use pretty much any staircase here for a fast flight. The coolest one in my opinion is this, using this ramp just outside both bases to fly back up to the bridge. It's surprisingly easy to do when you know how to trip, and it's really useful in certain situations. Just try not to fall in the water when trying this one. There's also this really useful tramp when you're trying to avoid some people or even ambush some people. The tramp and the surf combine together. You can tramp on this entire sewer pipe to get really fast access to the base or from the base. It's really good for ambushing pyros trying to be smarter than you. Speaking of surfing while tramping as demo knight, did you know you can surf on these pipes as any class? You can actually surf the sides of these sewer pipes and get to your destination really quickly compared to normally walking, for example, as heavy. Now, here's a couple little pixel boosts that I haven't mentioned yet. They're not particularly useful, but thought I'd mention them anyway. You can use a mobility class to get up here. You can also use stickies through this little gap here to spawn camp. It's not particularly useful, but it works. I guess. On the red base, you can also get up on top of this roof, and even taunt here. It's a fun little spot, though not really useful. And that was a few cool tips in 2 Fort to give you a slight edge and maybe have a little bit of fun. Hope you enjoyed, as it's my first time making a video like this, and I hope you have fun in your 2 Fort games.